It's a bad time for men, he says. It doesn't matter if you're straight or gay, we're all fucked either way. I'm honestly pretty worried. Look at Harvey Weinstein. How is he to know the goalposts would change? I could be saying something totally harmless one day and have it become a prisonable offence the next. How are men supposed to keep up? Should I even be looking at you right now? I keep my face impassive and pretend he's not asked a question. At home, the fire spark of my kitchen thermostat leaps in urgent sporadic flames, roars loud and soft at night like waves rushing up and pulling away. Me too, me too. Don't we smile? Why did the fire smile? Because look how cute she is. That word, as the thermostat clicks and sparks. I dream fiercely I'm on a narrow rickety track, travelling far too fast above topiary and roosting birds in a wooden supermarket trolley with only one wheel. I'm killing it. Cute, 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 cute. It chugs menacingly.
What does this remind you of? He holds you by the shoulder and makes you listen. This time, it is not disco and you are relieved. You can't hear the woman moan, "I love to love you, baby," one single more time. It reminds you of playing the Smarties tube, blowing saliva bubbles through the soggy cardboard, holes bored with baby milk incisors. It's like a game of tug and war where no one is winning. It's like disembodied laughter. Like animals and small children running into room corners, hiding under tables, fat fingers pressed to mouths. Everything is all right. The sound is a tickling, a shallow, irregular breathing, and inflating with something outside itself, like a light lung with air. You shrug and you say, "I don't know, I guess it reminds me of, like, Paris." You notice your voice going up at the end and vow to fix it. The dancers bring you into their dark studio.
Oh.
What does this remind you of? That's not music, he tells him, and his face flushes a choleric puce as he bangs his fist on the steering wheel. Not music, he shouts, throttling mauve, swerving. Everything is music. You're driving through the city you'll one day move to. You don't know that yet. Everything is music. I'm blue dubba dee dubba die versus free jazz. What's free about it, you think? The buildings are taller than at a home, and it's raining into your heads, which you fill with kebab to soak up the acid. The life rattle of a copper kettle, the raining of small currency coins, your grandmother sneezing.
I quite like the idea of what a grandma sneezing currency coins, like a weird kind of quirk of a fairy tale character or something.
The mice chewing cables in the walls, acupuncture needles, follow the piper.
Well, when you put them together, acupuncture needles, follow the piper, sounds like a slightly creepy event in a fairy tale, maybe the same fairy tale with a grandmother who sneezes currency coins.
Lukewarm glass noodles, catching your funny bone, toddler snowsuits, a little death, laughable anticlimax.
Ah, oh, that reminds me of this opera scene that was performed at university, maybe Eugene Onegin, the Tchaikovsky opera. It was a duel scene, two characters on stage, they draw their pistols, they fire, one falls down, and a side character runs up to them, checks his pulse, and just sings, "Dead." It was just the obviousness of it that made me giggle.
Close the sash windows.
So, following on from the Tchaikovsky opera memory, I could try writing a mini prelude for an imagined fairy tale opera that would feature a grandmother that sneezes coins, a piper chased by acupuncture needles, and somewhere along the way, slightly comical demise.
Thank you.
Thank you. Using a dynamic routing protocol with IPv6.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.